Taking control of the elements, making it a mind, making it a mind, touching upon the elements. Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to Astold by Paula. As you guessed it, this is not your regular Astold by Paula video. What do I mean by that? Well, you're looking at a whole new Paula. No, I'm just kidding. On the real, you're going to see a different side of me though, because this is about to be my med school related vlog series. So this is called The Med Corner. The reason why I've decided to do this Med Corner series is because I kind of feel like I have a lot to share in terms of medicine and being a med student that I have not yet shared with you guys. And I had already planned on getting to this point, but now I feel like I'm at a point where I'm really comfortable and I can give good feedback about my medical experiences. So I'm just going to quickly give you guys a brief introduction about what this vlog series is going to entail and what you guys can expect next year. Okay, so you guys probably know from my last vlog post, if you don't, check it out, that I am in Poland and I am here for med school. The med school that I am at right now has 6-year and 4-year programs. I am in the 4-year postgraduate program for medicine. The reason being, I already have a sciences degree. I've covered a lot of the sciences needed for med school. So basically this year that we're doing, this first year, is clinical sciences. And the next year we go on to rotations within the hospital. So yeah, I know some people in my class have even been exempted from some of the classes in our clinical sciences, but yeah, I wasn't doing that because I kind of am rusty, so I need to go over some of the sciences. Plus there's a few sciences that I've never taken before that I feel like I should maybe, just maybe, study if I want to become a doctor. So yeah, that said, this program is, I guess, a little bit more accelerated in the sense that they expect us to already know all of this. So I decided next year when I start off the series, I want to share with you guys study tips. You know, most of you guys will find this vlog because you're looking for study tips. I started to watch most medical vlogs because I was looking for advice on how to make it through med school. So now I just watch them because I enjoy them and I can relate to them. But I know most of you will expect to have a little bit of like advice, so I'm gonna try and do the best I can to give you advice on what I do and what I find works. My habits change depending on what subject I'm studying because the style has to change. Like, you cannot study the same way you study for anatomy as you do for biochemistry, and that's kind of what I'm gonna try to share with you guys. And I will also try to find out from my friends what they do and share that with you guys, so you guys can figure out what works best for you, because you know, we all have very different study styles. It cannot be said enough that it's very important that you find something that works for you and stick to it. So I'll go more in depth with that next year. What else will I be talking about? Well, as anybody who's been part of the medical application process, whether it's pre-med, MCATs, being in med school, you know you have to be like 10 steps ahead, you know, in everything that you do. One of the things that I'm going to be mentioning is my preparing for residency process. I am looking to do residency in Germany, South Africa, or the US, and so that will entail some examinations, board type examinations that I will need to do. So in preparing for those, I plan to just share a little bit of the information of what I'll be doing, and hopefully, you know, other people going through the same process will find it useful too. Right now I'm very focused on the USMLE, so I'm trying to have a 2-year preparedness for step one. USMLE has 3 parts, but I will go into detail with all of this when I get to that point. What else will I be talking about? Well, I also want to talk about clinical rotations. As you might or might not know, I am very interested in international health, and so some of the things I'm trying to do during my time in med school is do clinical rotations in my own country, Namibia, and abroad. So I'm hoping to be able to share some of those experiences with you guys starting next year. So cross fingers for that, and I will also give more information about how one can go about doing that. What other things do I want to share with you guys? I want to share my daily life. I'm going to try and get as much of my daily routine in for you guys to see. That said, there will be limitations because there's certain places I just will not be able to take you. For instance, anatomy. We have anatomy classes with human bodies, cadavers, and it is just medically unprofessional for me to record something like that. So there's certain things that I will not be able to share with you guys, but I hope I can show you as much as possible about my daily life, and you know, you guys can get a feel for it and a feel for what medical school is, especially in Europe, because I think it differs from America somewhat. What else? Feel free to ask me questions. And I am more than happy to put up specialty vlogs. What do I mean by that? I mean, I have done application process for the US and from Poland, and I'm pretty knowledgeable in applications for the UK, Czech Republic, and Hungary. So if you have questions about those processes, feel free to send me an email, and I can do a blog post pertaining to that and any specific questions you might have related to those. I also will be sharing tips on nutrition and wellness. So, you know, what to eat. Well, not really what to eat. I am not a health freak by any sense, and I'm not a fitness junkie, but I am getting to a point where I'm improving upon myself every single time. And so in this journey, I feel like I can share it with you guys because I'm constantly changing things to try and make myself better at being more well-rounded. And so I'll be sharing things like nutrition, good foods to eat in med school that will keep you going, and fitness, you know, mostly yoga and aerobics. Unfortunately, I don't really do weightlifting or other intense things, so you know, that might be a little bit limited, but I'll get into that later on when I do those blog posts. And then also mental wellness, because that's very, very important for med school. Other things that I would like to share, also resources. You will find when you get to med school, it's not so much that you have so much to do. Well, it is that you have so much to do, but it's also how effective you are. So this is where studying right comes into play, and having the right resources. Because sometimes you could be putting in overtime reading a textbook that's not translating to you. So you have to be very good at getting things done efficiently. So that's one of the things I will share. I will share book resources, recommendations on books that I think are good in terms of like covering basic materials and covering more maybe in-depth advanced material more fluidly, so that it doesn't feel like it's such a thick read and you can get through it quickly but efficiently. What else will I be talking about? Online resources, YouTube channels that I think are pretty good. You know, other platforms, so like Essential Anatomy or like Anki app. So yeah, I'll be doing all that stuff. I'll be discussing that, and hopefully these things will be useful to other pre-med and med students alike. I will last but definitely not least consider also reviewing medical papers. At the moment, I'm considering reviewing medical studies related to pediatrics, just because that's what I'm interested in, pediatrics and neonatology. But I'm not yet sure if this is going to happen. It might happen a little bit later on along down the line. So if you guys are interested, let me know, and by popular demand, I can fast track that as well. So yeah, I think that's about it. If you guys have any questions, concerns, suggestions, definitely suggestions. I'd love to suggestions. Like, you know, I haven't started the series yet, so there's still so much I can do with it. And I would greatly, greatly, greatly appreciate any feedback. So feel free to do your thing in the comments. And subscribe, obviously, so that you can get my new blog post next year in 2017, guys. 2017! So yeah, that's about it. I wish you guys a happy new year. And I can't wait to see your lovely faces in the new year as we start this new series. Ciao!